So last day we have seen how the globalization or what is globalization and what are the factors which enable globalization. I have explained you technology is one of the factors which enable globalization. In that technology, the technology used in transport, we have taken container as one of the important technology which can reduce the time and reduce the cost. Cost of transport can be reduced and time of loading and unloading can be reduced. So container is one of the important technology used in transport or in the trade. Another thing that is we have seen one of the example that is information technology. How information technology is applied to conduct the trade or to enable globalization. We have taken the example of London-based magazine, which give text of the magazine to Delhi-based office, and the office make it print and everything, design and everything, and it is transported to London. Then the London magazine dealer or London magazine publishing company, they can give the payment through e-banking to the Delhi-based office. So this way it enable globalization or information technology enable globalization. We can see that there are three important movement which happened in globalization: movement of people, movement of information, movement of people, movement of investment and technology, and movement of goods and services. So these all create or it enable globalization. And in that we have taken technology as one of the important factor which enable globalization. Okay. Now we are going to study about the new topic that is known as liberalization. Liberalization of trade and investment. What do you mean by liberalization? Liberalize means to regulate, to liberate or to make free of trade and investment. Trade and investment is made it free. That is known as liberalization. Here I have explained you before about the Chinese toys, which have flourished in the in Chinese toys manufacturing company flourished by getting profit from India. And these Chinese toys, if it is imported to India, it is imported in India, then if suppose the government wants to regulate the trade, control the trade, the government can put taxes on that Chinese toys. If the Chinese toys, taxes are put on Chinese toys, the price of Chinese toys can be increased. When price of Chinese toys increase, there can be less demand for the Chinese toys. So gradually, the Chinese toys manufacturing company cannot earn any profit from the trade with India because of the taxes on import. So here, tax on import is a barrier which regulate the foreign trade. So tax on import is known as the trade barrier. Taxes on import is known as a trade barrier. Here the government government fix the import taxes or tax on import according to its needs and according to the quantity of the things. How much quantity the country wants and what type of goods the country needs. According to that, it wants to get more, it wants to have a good trade, then it can reduce the tax. And suppose we don't want to get, we don't want much thing or we don't want much quantity, then we can or the government can put taxes on that that commodities. So it is upon the government that to put taxes or to fix the taxes on imports. Tax on import is known as the trade barrier. The trade barrier is one of the important topic we have to study here. That is, after the independence, the government of India has put some trade barrier or some taxes were charged on some imports. Means government did not make other countries to import the things to India. Why the government did such movement? Because during Indian independence, during India's independence, our companies or our industries were flourishing, or they have just started. The first attempt, some of the many industries which have just started their work, or industrialization which just started. So during this time, suppose other companies' products would reach to Indian market, obviously our industries would be closed and people will demand for the other imported goods. So that government has made, or government has put some taxes on these imports, and government has taken the trade barrier in order to regulate the foreign trade. This was to make our industries to just grow. This was one of the important attempt by the government after independence. But the things changed after 1991. The attempt, or this idea, or this, so after 1991, this scenario changed. The government started removing the trade barriers. Okay, so we have seen that after independence, or during independence, government put some trade barrier in order to make our industries grow. But after 1991, government has removed that trade restrictions, or removed that trade barriers. Why did the government do such attempt? Because here government, or here the during this time 1991, our industries were already grown. We have, or our Indian industries were capable to compete with other foreign industries during 1991. So here we have to increase, or in India's industries, or Indian industries have a better platform to increase the quality of goods by competing in the world market. So that in order to compete with other countries' products, the government has removed the trade restrictions, or removed the trade barrier. This was one of the important movement, or important feature, that this this type of removing trade barrier or restrictions is known as liberalization. So liberalization means removing the trade barrier, or trade the taxes on goods and investment, both investment and taxes on goods. Investment in developing countries, MNCs, we have seen MNCs were started getting, or started the opportunity to come to start to build its industries in developing countries because of liberalization. When taxes on this investment and trade were removed, it gave way for liberalization. That happened in 1991. So when this liberalization started, Indian industries improved its quality of products, because it has to compete with the other countries' products, and thereby the quality of the products increased. Some of the Indian industries have raised to the level of MNCs because of competition and improving quality of the products. Many of the Indian industries were raised to the standard of multinational companies. This was another attempt. So here we can see the government has taken two type of methods. First, they have put the trade barrier. Second time, they have removed the trade restrictions. These two situations, according to the situation, the government can change the policy. This liberalization was welcomed by the world international organizations such as WTO and other world countries, developed countries, welcomed the attempt of India of liberalization. And this paved way for multinational companies, in foreign trade increased, and Indian products were also started selling in other countries' market. These are the important thing you have to keep it in mind. Here we have to see the role of WTO, that is the international organization known as World Trade Organization. The aim of World Trade Organization is to liberate, or to liberalize the trade. to make the trade free. But actually, WTO play a different role with developed countries and developing countries differently. One of the things that WTO instructs every countries to liberalize the trade, but developed countries, we can see the thing that developed countries, they make the trade, or with this liberalization of trade, they get a lot of profit. Here in USA, most of the people who are engaged in the tertiary sector and very less people are engaged in the primary sector, that is agriculture. And the share of primary sector or agriculture to national income or GDP is less. Where in India, it is, or developing countries like India, the share of primary sector or agriculture is more, agriculture and the share of agriculture and people who work in agriculture are more. They depend on agriculture. So in such situation, we can see the government of USA or US government, they give lot of subsidies or lot of money for farmers, for agricultural production and also for trade or selling in the market, selling to the other countries. Here, the farmers produce products which are more quantities of products are produced in USA and they sell it in their market, surplus things, surplus products, they sell it to other countries' market or markets of other countries. So first we can see US farmers get lot of money, massive money from US government for their production and also selling in the market or exporting to other countries. When they sell, US farmers sell their products in other countries, the price become cheaper because US farmers get massive support or massive money from government. That is why the prices of these agricultural products are cheaper. And when it reached to the developing countries or markets of developing countries, cheaper agricultural products from USA and consider substantially higher prices of the developing countries products we can see. So here in the market itself, the products of USA or agricultural products of USA is preferred over, preferred to the Indian product or the developing countries product because it is substantially cheaper. This is one of the important reason that here international organization like WTO, when it instructs to every world countries that to liberate the trade, how the Indian farmers can flourish or how the Indian farmers can sell their products. Because in the market, they have to face a stiff competition from the US products. So here the farmers get a loss and the country, developing country cannot progress. But developed country get an advantage. Here the WTO has to instruct properly to the developed countries or the US government not to support the farmers, so that their price, agriculture products prices can be increased. Otherwise, the WTO has to instruct the developing countries not to liberalize the trade, or the government of developing countries can put some trade barrier. But WTO instructs everyone to liberalize the trade. So WTO has to look after every countries in a proper manner. With developed countries, they have to insist the government, or WTO has to insist the government not to support the farmers, by giving massive money or lot of money, or give the instruction to the developing countries to make some tax barrier or to put some tax barrier. This is one of the important debate which is going on with the developing countries and the problems of developing countries with the WTO rules. So every developing countries wants the WTO to make or to consider their problem and to flourish their products in the market.